This video is about how to create and assign priorities. To navigate to priorities, go to the left-hand navigation three steps down. You can see in this test account there are already some priorities set up in here for us to explore. To add a new one, simply click Add Priority in the top left corner. A window will pop out allowing you to fill out different information about your new priority. The only two required fields for each priority are priority name and priority owner. It will automatically populate with the username that you're logged in as. To change and assign to someone else, simply erase your name out and then search for an alternate user. Once you've completed those two steps, you can already save this priority to add it to the home page. To keep creating this priority, I will go to the far right-hand side and click Edit. The same pop-up opens back up, and I can continue down this list of different items to edit. You really should never need to use all the different customizable options. However, I will go through each of them so that you have an idea of what all this language means. We use the language parent priority and child priority when we want to link priorities together. If I wanted to attach this priority, let's say to roll out new employee handbook, I would just search for a few keywords in that priority name and attach the two. I'll now expect this priority to roll underneath the Rollout New Employee Handbook priority when I save it. You have the option to add in more details about the goal within the description section. Here, I recommend writing in why this goal actually helps the growth of the company or how it will affect the company and this person's role. Tags are keywords that help you search for a particular subset of goals. There are some options already created in this test account. However, you can always create one on the fly within the priority itself. Visibility. You can set visibility on a priority. The default will always be set to everyone. And you should not have to change this, as we recommend full transparency and visibility throughout each organization in order to actually see the increase in accountability. However, you do have the option to hide priorities for viewing by only particular users or teams. Priority type. The most important thing for you to understand about priorities is that there are three different priority type options. This is how you measure your success in achieving the goal, what it actually takes to get to 100% complete. The first option is your KPI, or Key Performance Indicator. Some companies call this an OKR, which are objectives and key results. Here, you will set your specific number-based target and track the target against the current value over time. The next priority type is called a rollup. This is a type of priority where the progress is determined by its child priorities. It is calculated by taking the average of the percent completion of all the priorities that branch out below it. The last option is task-driven, which means that the priority's progress is determined by the number of tasks that are attached underneath. If there are 10 total tasks and 5 are complete, then your priority would be at 50% complete. You can add a task to any priority, no matter what type you have selected. Tasks will only affect the percentage complete if it's specifically marked as a task-driven priority. Lastly, there's a comment section should you need to make an extra note about your priority. All right, now that you're read up on the basics, let's take us through creating an example priority. Let's start from the top, from the Manage Priorities page, and click Add Priority. This priority can be called Release New Software, for example's sake. I can erase the existing person's name and assign it to another user if need be. For now, I'll just leave it as John Smith. This example is a pretty vague priority name that will take lots of different arms of the company and specific objectives in order to complete. Therefore, I'm going to mark this priority as a rollup and go into further detail below. Our measure of success for release new software is making sure that all the priorities underneath it are also complete. So let's create some child priorities. Why do you really need to release a new software, and how will you actually know that it has been a success? One of the main reasons is to decrease the number of manual processes for the end user. We're going to make sure that this is very specific and actually say from 12 to 6 processes. We'll remember to link it to the release new software priority. And then since this is a specific number-based priority, it will be KPI driven. Our start value was 12 processes, and our target value is 6 processes. Let's say right now we're at about 9. We're halfway there. I'll save this priority and let's take a look. You can see here that since the child priority is at 50%, it's also affecting the parent priority. When creating your priorities, the most important thing to keep in mind is your measure of success and what it really takes to reach 100%. In the next video, we'll review how to update the priorities that you've created.